Hello everyone, and welcome to the sinus congestion version of the Megabuild project. I am currently coming down with the flu, I think, so my voice is going to sound a little bit different today. I apologize in advance. I will try to keep the hacking and wheezing to a minimum, but I wanted to get this out today because I got a feeling my voice is only going to get worse, and I just, you know, I don't want to wait a week and a half to do things. So we're here at Coastal Cottage, and there is no more gateway because I have switched mods. I tore the buildings down. Those are my, you know, bookmarks, and this, of course, the pole is for the provisioner turnaround point. I am using this as a test bed to play with the new mods that I have selected, and we're just gonna do some random crap here. That's it, you know, that's the warehouse, the garage. This is the first structure I built trying to learn how to do this. I built the comms tower because, of course, the Megabuild has to have the comms tower. Now, if you watched the end of the last video, you'll have seen this already, but if you have not, here it is. Basically, what I'm going to do as a theme is I'm going to make this a raider outpost that we have commandeered and repurposed. So they're all gonna be raidery looking shacks. I doubt this is gonna be a very large one in terms of you know, scale. Like, it's not gonna be Starlight, but we will see how it goes. And so anyway, here's the comms tower with the, you know, the console and the array and whatever the hell. It's kind of sitting on the side. The dish does point to Finch, which is gonna be the next hub. And that's what the style is going to look like here. So, let's go over to here, and taking a page from the Settlements and Survival recent builds, I'm going to steal a Bethesda structure to start this off. The one I have chosen this time around is one of my favorites. It is at Easy City Downs, and of course I have sped the tour up because it's, you know, a tour, I don't need to go slow speed, and this is quite as long enough as it is. But this one here I wanted to use for a long time, but it's got that L-shaped corner piece, the one you see right here, and there's really no way to duplicate that in vanilla, so I had to wait until I got mods. But if you look here, you've got these two corner pieces. They're the same piece, just, you know, rotated. You can see the walls the same pattern. And of course it leads in this way, there's no doors. And this little hut is, it sleeps too. It's got two mattresses, a mattress and sleeping bag. It's got a table, some sandbags, another one of those wood corner pieces with the same kind of pattern so I can remember which one it is. But this one's not symmetrical. It's sort of, you know, off kilter, and it uses the balcony pieces for its pathways. But you've got a little, you know, sitting area out here with a little ledge that goes around the outside, which should be super easy to duplicate because that's just a snap fest there. But yeah, nice little observation post, lots of windows, lots of places to look out, a little balcony around the outside. Should be fairly straightforward to duplicate, and we'll go from there. Yeah, somebody just knocked on the door. I'm going to ignore that crap because I'm recording. I don't care. Whatever the hell that is. They can't be delivering anything, so they're probably just salesmen. Anywho, so let's go back to the build. Now, I want to go ahead and start with this and say, well, let's review the mods that I did. Now, the ones I did do, I did, that knock is really distracting. I hope they go away. I did, when I asked y'all for mods, y'all gave me some very, very good suggestions. I want to thank you very much. I went through every single one of them. And I just want to just share with you what I found. So you'll have, maybe if you want to switch mods, you can go in there and start looking at stuff. Now, first off, people suggested thematic and practical and woody stuffs. Those aren't available on the Xbox, which is what I'm on. They're on PC, so those were disqualified. I looked for custom vanilla assets, and apparently it is no longer in the work in progress section for XP1. So that one was off the table. So the first one I checked out was G2M. G2M is very nice, very fast, 3 seconds to open, very, very, very quick. Had a lot of really good wood pieces I haven't seen elsewhere. It had an entire section for the Sunshine Tidings cabin pieces, which was cool as hell. I was like, that's neat. So if you ever want to do Sunshine Tidings, you can do that. It's got a Pier Beach set too, which is like the Dornhagen stuff, and it seems to have everything with walls. Not a lot of furniture, no cardboard boxes, no accessories, nothing like that. And it had injection, so it needed to be uninstalled. It had a, you know, a chem to do that. So I was like, yeah, this is good. I mean, I wish it had more stuff in it, and I wish it didn't need to be uninstalled because it was laid out pretty well. But yeah, that wasn't something I could use. Sediment Object Expansion Pack was another one. The default setup, there's a couple of different configurations, which is really cool. You can say, you know, put it in its own menu or have it blend into the other menus. And the places it put stuff in the regular menus made a lot of sense. So I like that part a lot, but it didn't have a lot of vanilla assets that I would want. Didn't have any wood, didn't have a lot of other stuff. But if you want to do theme builds, like you know, Minutemen or Railroad or Brotherhood of Steel or Institute. It's got a lot of really cool stuff in there for that. And it has a lot of advanced effects stuff, like fire effects and different kinds of turrets. And so it's basically an alternate assets mod. You know, it's really good for expanding the types of things you can build. So if you're a thematic builder or if you're somebody who wants to do that kind of stuff, this thing is really, really, really cool. Not something I would use, but I can definitely see where it would be very, very cool for people who would like it. And of course, it also has injection, so it needs to be uninstalled. Quick to open though, 5 seconds. Then there was Workshop Rearranged. This was the other one I looked at. This one is like USO. It has everything. It's blended into the menus where it belongs. Very, very well laid out. It literally has everything I would ever want. Forklifts, boxes, paper posters, some junk items, all the bathroom fixtures. I mean, it's a solid, complete mod. Its downside though, it's like USO. And it takes 17 seconds to open. And I'm like, I can't do that. So if you're looking for a USO alternative, that's one mod that has everything, but that is admittedly slow to open, but it is very well organized, you gotta check that one out. So the one I went with, of course, as you've seen here is, can I do this? I can't scroll down. I went with the Master Plan and Vanilla Extensions and Settlements and Supplies Expanded. This one was the fastest to open by a significant margin. This thing pops open in 3 seconds, even with OCD loaded. So very, very happy about that. It's a standalone category under wood. It's got multiple sub menus. It's got tons and tons and tons of the scrappy vanilla pieces I like. It changes a lot of the sinking and snapping properties of a lot of pieces, which I'm still kind of undecided about. I mean, I do like the fact that it snaps, but I don't like the fact that if a piece snaps, I can't rug glitch it. So placement is going to be a little bit more difficult. On the other hand, the shack supports here work a lot better than the ones in USO. They're super easy to group select, as you can see here, and they're really soft on the tips and the edges, which means I can put them pretty much wherever I want. So bonus points there. A lot of solid wood pieces. It's got, you know, a lot of accessories that I want. I mean, it's missing cardboard boxes and stuff like that, the little trash stuff, but that's cool. And it doesn't need to be uninstalled. It doesn't inject. You do have to get the master plan. You have to get another mod to install with it, but all this author's mods go with it. So it's like, yeah, you know, whatever, it's fine. It's not a lot of overhead. So for the rest of the stuff, for the trash stuff and all the other crap I wanted, I went with Elven Blossoms items, okay? And I went with low polys. No, I did not go with low poly settlement furniture pack, but it's got, but the low poly one, that one goes really good with settlement objects expanded because it's a lot of theme stuff. And if you're making theme builds, man, get low poly stuff if you can, because it's fantastic. He's got every single piece in there. But I went with more workshop objects, which is a very, very tiny mod, and it has all the like workshop stuff, diagnostic carts, hand trucks, push carts, floor jacks, bottle crates, toolboxes, really, really good stuff. Doesn't have a lot of overlap with settlement objects expanded. So I didn't have a lot of duplicates, which was nice. And then I went with static basket and bins, another tiny mod, but it has barrels, trash cans, shopping carts, plastic crates, wood crates, cardboard boxes, all the little tiny stuff I wanted. So yeah, so okay, so here is the first one. So I went with vanilla extensions. You'll see the mod list. I've got it, of course, linked in the description. So there's that. I'm done reading off of my list. There's that. But yeah, I really like, for my style of building, I'm really liking this mod. It was a little tricky to figure out because things are, a lot of stuff is in the top level menus, but then most of it is in its own dedicated menu. And I forget a lot which is which. There's going to come a point up here where I build this railing and there's a gap in it. And I try to put a sandbag in there because I know I saw a sandbag, but I couldn't remember where it was. So I basically cut out 2 minutes of me scrolling through menus because who wants to see me just sitting there scrolling through menus? And I couldn't find them anyway. Turns out they were in the sub menu where it was before. So in other news, we are doing the Mega Build, and I am doing, I am playing another Moribund World character. I created a new Moribund World character because it turns out the first one I made, the first Moribund World build I did at Red Rocket, that character had used USO for a lot of stuff, and I forgot to load her and delete all that stuff before I got rid of USO. So I went ahead and deleted her and started a new character. And when I did that, at the time, Loco4Pack had started a challenge over on his channel for settlement. How do we evolve a settlement? Building an evolved settlement. What you do basically is you go, you play a couple of levels, you build, you take like 2 minutes and show them what you built, right? And then every week you get four levels and you build more stuff, right? With the eventual goal being you have to have all level three shops, you have to have a scavenger, you have to have a guard, and it has to be a self-sufficient settlement. But it's a really cool idea, and I was really excited for it. But it turns out my Moribund World character, yeah, there's the cut. My Moribund World character didn't qualify because he had gotten too fat, he had leveled too much already. And the settlement I was building on a sanctuary, and Loco chose Starlight as the one to build on. So I'll leave a link to the video in the description, his challenge video. If you are at all interested in this, I would recommend it. So far, it has been really fun because I had to start a new character. So I started two new characters in the last week and a half. But since I'm going to be sick this weekend, that's probably for the best. Anyway, so the second guy, I am using, you know, vanilla extensions, and I'm trying to learn this mod more. I'm getting better at finding where I'm what I'm going for. So our next video in the Megabuild series will definitely be less menu thrashy, because I'm more comfortable with knowing where stuff is and figuring out what's going on. So I'm doing his challenge in vanilla. I'm doing his challenge with a regular character in normal mode. I'm doing a Moribund World run through with the sanctuary base in survival mode, and then of course I've got settlements and survival and this going. So you may see the video themes may be a bit random coming up, but hey, it's content, right? You'll have a lot of new stuff to look at, and if you're using vanilla extensions, maybe this will, or any mod really that uses a lot of vanilla items, you can do that. So that's what's going on with that. So, my voice does sound different because I did finally spring for a new microphone. I had to play with it quite a great deal to get it to be at the right levels and stuff, and I'm not sure how it sounds. So if this sounds really strange, I mean, it could be my voice, yeah, or it could be the microphone. I don't really know. But yeah, you can see here this with the vanilla extensions, one of the things it took away is the ability for railings to snap to the front of doorways like it does in vanilla, right? But you can snap railings to the cracks between floor pieces and wall pieces, which is a kind of a neat thing. It's really kind of a cool thing to do. So I finally give up and punt, and I think I put a railing on the inside of the double rail. Yeah, here we go. Boop, stick that there. So that's decent. So yeah, that's what's going on with that. Still thinking about the Patreon thing. I did sort of start setting up a page, and oh my God, do they bomb you with emails or what? Clearly this is being, with judging from the themes and the subjects and the topics of these emails they've been sending me, it's clear that this is for someone who's not me, because all this stuff they're sending me, I'm like, yeah, this doesn't really apply to me. I'm not really looking for this type of thing. But, you know, who knows? We'll see how it goes. But, yeah, so still pondering that. And, but just doing the building thing, you know, doing the building thing, doing the playing and the building thing. What else is going on, man? I don't really know. I had a whole bunch of stuff to talk about. Oh yeah, so as I'm playing through the games, I've already got two characters. The challenge guy is like level, I think he just hit 8, and the Moribund World guy is like 15 or something like that now. And so I've been spending a lot of time in the Northwest, which is something I don't really do a lot with my higher level characters. And I went to Grey Garden again, and for some reason, I don't know why this got my attention, but I started wondering, here's these robots, right? They're programmed to raise crops, food, in a greenhouse, but they were set up before the war, right? Okay, so they're gonna be doing, they're gonna have crops that are regular carrots, regular tomatoes, regular corn, regular whatever mute fruit was, and they're programmed, right? They're coded to do this. Would they have personality? Sure. But I started wondering, how the hell do they know what mute fruit is? How do they know how it's pronounced? How do they know to grow it? How do they learn to deal with mutated plants? Because, I mean, mutated plants are theoretically different than regular plants. I mean, potatoes didn't exist before the war, for sure. These mutant, gigantic, friggin' eggplant-looking carrots certainly didn't. And so I started to kind of think about, like, I guess their AI is really a lot better than we give them credit for, because not only can they learn new types, new ways of growing things, but they can also learn how to pronounce them and know what they're called. And yeah, so anyway, that's one of the little things I I think about this stuff too much, I suppose. But yeah, you can see here the snapping, right? That pillar snaps, like, look at that, bang, it just jumps right to that thing. Although I am happy to have this piece finally, this the marble supports with the crossbeam, because that shows up a lot in Bethesda stuff too. But this here shack, this one here on this side, is not really motivated. It's not really inspired by anything. This is just something I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna build this thing. What they are good for, those groups light, because they're tall, those cross member pieces. And this little hut, I don't know, I kind of like this. It's like I said, it's lumpy like the other one. It looks like something you might see in the game. Probably not though, not with that entryway, because that entryway is definitely not AI pathing friendly. Oh, there's a dog, so Longfellow's around here somewhere. Yep, there he is. So yeah, what I didn't realize when I was building this is that the newer, smaller guard hut, or you know, outpost or lookout thing, it's too close to the settlement boundary, the building boundary. So I can't put a wall around the outside of it. So I got to figure out something. I think I moved it. But here we go. I got my double height walls, and I'm trying to figure out, I want to put something in front of here, and it's just snapping to everything. And my God, it's so aggressively snappy. Learning how to group select with this mod is a challenge, because I'm going to have to start, I think, building two concrete pillars, right? Just so I can have one pillar snap and then build the other pillar so I can group select with, the way I've normally done. And of course, you can't do it with rugs anymore either. So I have to figure out some other random method. I mean, they do sync, but one of the properties of doing rug drops and group select with rugs is it removes collision. And group selecting a piece that's snap happy is not going to remove collision. I'm not gonna be able to do this where I can just sink it into a wall, you know? So I'm still struggling with that aspect of this particular mod. And of course, there's one thing I don't like about it, is that the snap points on picket fences are all, it's like all over the place. So yeah, so now I'm thinking, okay, now it's time to tour, but no, I don't like the outside of that. I'm looking at the outside, see, I'm gonna go back into build mode, and I'm gonna say, yeah, that outside wall, but see how fast that is? That is so nice. So yeah, if you like building like this, if you like building scrappy, definitely take a look at vanilla extensions. It is a fantastic little mod for what it does. And it has a lot of features in it too that I'll probably never use, like the prefab you just saw pop up. The prefabs are cool as hell, but they're too big for my particular purposes. But yeah, we got a pretty good thing here. And Elven Blossoms items are really neat too. I mean, it's really a random sampling of stuff, but it's really cool because it's got a guard station with a minigun, and I like that on a tripod. So, okay. All right, folks, here we go. Here's the tour of the first two buildings on the reworked Megabuild project. We are going to be doing a gateway, entryway. I don't know what I'm going to do about a provisioner stop here, but we'll figure it out. We've got ourselves a small little guard hut here with some pretty good lumpiness to it, pretty good asymmetry, good sight lines. I love this chain link corner. I love this thing because you can see out, you know, but it's protected. So it's like, okay, it's a good observation post. He can see the entryway. You can see through the slats if you need to. There's places to duck and cover. There's places to put a chair or, you know, have a bed or whatever. And then this one here, of course, there's at least two beds you could put in here, or one bed and a lot of detailing. I got to figure out how to do the sandbags too, because the sandbags snap too. And that means you can't rug them. So it's like, well, I got to figure out a way to do this. But again, good sight lines on the balcony here. Good sight lines are over the railings. You've got some good space in here. One neat thing about this type of building is that you have a lot of interior supports, which is really cool for visual stuff. Pathing and placing furniture is a little less than optimal, but I'll figure something out, I guess. And then we'll go up here. I think this will be it. Yes, it is. All right, folks. And there we go. I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.